much for joining us on the Bounder BB Show today. I have one of my HGTV personalities that I love the best, John Giddings. He's going to give us tips and trends on designing your outdoor summer space. John, welcome back to the show.
Thank you, Valder. How are you?
I've been having a fabulous life, and I've been sprucing up my backyard. Give me a hand here.
Well, you know, let me tell you about some of the trends that are very popular this summer in backyard design.
Okay.
So, surprisingly enough, reflective surfaces are huge this year. Typically, the backyard is about containers in the sort of terracotta or glazed family. But this year, reflective surfaces are huge. So if you find something mirrored or glass, vases are big, create groupings and really mix and match, and you'll find that you're right in with the trends this year.
Oh, that sounds great, John. I have a huge mirror I bought at a garage sale hanging on my patio wall because it's beautiful.
Maybe you created this trend.
I could have. I didn't even know I was in a trend. That sounds good. What else do you want us to know? And let me see if I have it.
Absolutely. How are you with outdoor fabrics? Have you fully embraced outdoor fabrics into your life, Elder?
I don't know about fully, but I do. I do have some outdoor fabric.
Good. I think they've really come a long way. Finally, they used to be a good selection, I would say, but this year it's great. You can find all sorts of patterns, all sorts of fabrics. There are great outdoor rugs also available, either woven plastics, highly mildew resistant, easy to clean, and a great way of bringing the indoors out. I find that if you can make your outdoor spaces really an extension of the same kind of personality that you have on the inside of your home, you're going to be spending a lot more time out there.
You're perfectly right. I decided to make my indoor porch just an extension of the family room where everyone gathers. So you really don't, there's no separation almost.
Exactly. How great. And another thing, by the way, is lighting. People seem to ignore lighting a little too much. I think, yes, it's important to have lighting out there, but it's even more important to break up your spaces with the lighting. So you've got little vignettes. A fire pit is a great way to not only add light, but warmth and personality and atmosphere. And you can find them in all sorts of different scales, sizes, shapes, and styles. So more traditional, more modern, whatever you want, you got.
All right, then. Well, I'm going to skip that fire pit because I'm real clumsy. But what else do you have, John?
Well, you know, I don't know if you know about this, but usually when you're outside, you've got a lot of mosquitoes. Have you heard of mosquitoes, Valder? Do they exist
in
Dallas, Texas?
Yeah, I'm telling you, they're big as you and I, John.
I know. I spent a lot of time in Dallas. We did a couple specials there. And the architecture there is fantastic. You know, a lot of spaces outdoors to appreciate, but a lot of mosquitoes as well. And for me, I hate lathering on those chemical creams, and that's why I've really started espousing these misters and repellers that Terminix has come out with called All Clear, because they're very natural, they're safe around kids, they're safe around food. You can clip them on your belt, or you can get the larger scale one for your table as a lantern, or for your backyard. And the great thing is you can just sort of clip it and forget about it, and they'll keep you mosquito free for a whole day.
I like that, John. Thank you so very much. Because you said something I didn't know. I've used the clip-on, but I didn't know all natural. I need the all natural. So I've got to get the Terminix one.
Yes, Terminix.com/mosquito will tell you everything you need to know, including the natural materials. It's made from like peppermint oil and cinnamon oil. It's really good stuff. It doesn't smell bad at all, and it's very safe around kids and food, so you'll appreciate it.
Oh, thank you. That's a great tip. Now, tell me about curb appeal, because we've been watching this for years and doing some of your little tricks. We're not as good as you, but we think we could be John Giddings one day now.
Absolutely. Can I give you the easiest thing to do for your curb appeal? If you've got those little yellow sticker parallelogram house numbers, rip those off this afternoon. And if you don't, I'm coming by tomorrow to rip them off for you. And install some proper house numbers, because it makes such a big difference. It's literally the first thing people see. Some proper house numbers, a new doormat, some color on your front door, and maybe even a new mailbox. If you've got one of those old crooked ones, get rid of it. And between those four things, you've reinvented your curb appeal, and everyone will appreciate you for it.
Well, you've been doing curb appeal and getting applause for that for a very long time. So continue doing that so that we can feel like we can accomplish something, John Giddings. Thank you for talking to us and giving us some summer tips.
Absolutely, Valder. Anytime.